Hey, what's this, man? What's going on, man?
I can't see myself.
I'm afraid that's one of the misfortunes of the cursed.
Hey, look here, man. You mean to tell me I ain't never gonna see my face again? I don't mind being a vampire and all that shit, but this really ain't hip. I mean, a man has got to see his face.
A concise and bittersweet phrase that sums up the main theme of the documentary, invisibility. It expresses the most prevalent motivation behind many Black speculative fiction creators over the years, to see their own image in narratives about the fantastical past and or the speculative future. Representations that have been, for the most part, neglected in the minds of white creators, but in the minds of Black creators, representations that have spoken loudly and clearly. My name is Emma's Lee Dukan, and I am the producer and director of The Invisible Universe, A History of Blackness in Speculative Fiction. This project, a journey of many years, has seen me travel across the United States, all in my effort to research and document the events and people who make up Black speculative fiction, and who are, in essence, an invisible universe. The scope of this project is vast. It will showcase over 150 years of Black creators using the genres of speculative fiction, namely fantasy, horror, and science fiction, to comment on, critique, and analyze the Black experience. As the images imagined by white and Black creators are compared and contrasted, patterns emerge. Where stories by white creators often marginalize non-white characters in their tales of extraterrestrials, futuristic technologies, distant planets, and alternate timelines, Black creators remove this privilege while often framing their narratives with themes of resistance, liberation, and independence. I have accumulated hundreds of hours of footage over the years of interviews and documentation of conferences, conventions, panels, performances, and other events. And now it's time to compile this footage into a film. And as Invisible Universe moves into post-production, we need your support. For many years, I have employed numerous fundraising strategies to continue production, from applying for and receiving grants, to soliciting for donations, to organizing fundraising events, to selling t-shirts. And I've received a plethora of in-kind support from many people and organizations in the community over the years. My hope and goal is that this next phase, post-production, will take Invisible Universe to the next level, where we as a community bring this documentary to fruition. What we need to do at this point is to begin by raising $20,000 for post-production. This includes funding for hiring an editor and acquiring the media, equipment, and software needed to undertake this task. In exchange for your financial donations, we have set up a number of perks that are not only unique and often one of a kind, but perks that will keep you informed and engaged with the Invisible Universe project. So that's it. To continue this project, I need the support of not only fans of people like Samuel Delany, Octavia Butler, Wesley Snipes, and Nichelle Nichols, but fans of 19th century revolutionary Black utopian fiction, and fans of zombie and voodoo-themed films like Night of the Living Dead and Eve's Bayou, and fans of Black comic books like Brother Man and Milestone Media's The Codaverse, and fans of Blaxploitation-era films like Blackula and Ganja and Hess, and especially those who are interested and involved in the burgeoning Afrofuturism movement. So please support the Invisible Universe project today by making a financial contribution and also spreading the word about our campaign. Thank you.